My name's Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in financial accounting. And in this video, we're going to talk about the relationship between two of the most important financial statements, the balance sheet and the income statement. Both of these statements contain crucial information about the financial performance of a company. And understanding the linkages between the two can be extremely beneficial to users of the financial statements. We'll start off with a quick high-level overview of both statements, and then jump right into the most important connections that help make the balance sheet and income statement such a dynamic duo. The balance sheet and income statement contain all kinds of valuable information regarding both the financial performance and health of a business. An income statement tells us about the profit or loss of a business over a period of time, whereas a balance sheet gives us more insight into the financial health of the business at a specific point in time. You can think of the relationship between these two financial statements like a Hollywood movie. The income statement captures the content of the movie. This is where the individual scenes take place, whereas the balance sheet is the overall health, or in this case, the whole production. It's the ending or the outcome resulting from all of the individual scenes. Let's look at an example. It's the opening scene of a movie. After a difficult month in September, a restaurant looks at their financials and is very disappointed with their performance. In looking at their income statement, they notice that their profit dropped significantly that month. That September income statement is just one scene out of the 12 scenes that year. But if they want to make sure the movie ends well, they need to make some key business decisions. So they decide to spend a bunch of money on a new social media advertising campaign in hopes that it will increase their revenues. That operational decision is captured within the next scene, also known as the income statement, as a marketing expense to the business. Consider the question though, how does this impact the company's balance sheet? First off would be the direct impact to the company's cash balance. Let's say the restaurant spent $10,000 cash on the marketing costs. Well, like we just saw, this would result in an increase to the company's expenses on their income statement. We would then see a corresponding impact to the company's balance sheet with a decrease of $10,000 to their cash balance. Even more importantly for the company, as the story progresses over the next few months, the goal would be for those increased marketing costs to ultimately result in more business and sales dollars by the end of the year. By the time we get to the end of the movie, hopefully this is all translated into more cash and equity on the company's December 31st year-end balance sheet. Now that we have a good understanding of the relationship between these two statements, let's run through a few common misconceptions. Not all expenses on the income statement decrease cash on the balance sheet in the same period. Sometimes we see costs in the income statement without a decrease to the company's cash on their balance sheet. This would happen when a company makes a purchase on credit and they've not yet physically handed over the cash. Instead of a decrease to the cash account, we would see an increase to the company's accounts payable, which is a liability for the organization. Another common misconception is that we can find the company's profit on their balance sheet. The profit for an individual period of time cannot be found on the balance sheet. We use the income statement for this purpose. However, the owner's equity section of the balance sheet reports the cumulative amount of profit that builds up over time and remains within the business. More on this to come. The real connection between the balance sheet and income statement results from the use of the double entry accounting system. What this means is that any accounting transaction that impacts the income statement will also directly impact the balance sheet. Ultimately, the components on the income statement result in the following effects to the owner's equity section of the balance sheet. Revenue or gains equals an increase to the equity. Expenses or losses will result in a decrease to equity. So let's look at how this all relates with an example of a company's owner equity. Owner's equity is the value left over to the owners of the company after we subtract the liabilities from all the assets within the organization. In this example, if we pop up the opening balance sheet at the start of December, we see that the company has $50,000 of owner's equity. If we fast forward to the end of the year and look at the company's December 31st balance sheet, we see that the owner's equity balance has now increased by $25,000 to a total of $75,000. Where did this $25,000 come from? Well, if we assume that no additional investment was brought into the organization that month, then it's highly likely that this came from something on the company's income statement. Let's do some investigation and pull up the income statement, which covers the operating activities of the whole month of December. And there's our answer. If we take that $100,000 in revenue, less the $75,000 in expenses, Here we have our $25,000 in net profit for the month of December. That $25,000 of profit is added to the company's previous owner's equity, bringing it from the original $50,000 up to the $75,000 at the end of the month. This demonstrates a clear linkage between the two statements and gives us some key insights into how we can use both financial statements to get a better understanding of the whole picture. And that brings us to the end of the video. It's important to remember that the balance sheet and income statement both include valuable information that can be used to gather insight into an organization. If we look at the income statement without considering the balance sheet, sometimes we could get lost in the weeds. On the other hand, if we only consider the information within the balance sheet, we may miss out on valuable scenes of the movie that contributed to the exciting ending. While each financial statement is extremely useful, we really need to consider them both in order to make an accurate assessment on the overall rating.